most people who have done any video editing are familiar with how to do pan and zoom in edit. But today, I'm gonna show you a few tricks you may not have tried.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
I'm gonna be using Filmora's pan and zoom, but even if you're using a different editing software, you can still use these very same techniques. The first one I wanna show you is the pan and zoom opener. I use this one all the time. You can certainly start your video just by starting your first clip like this. Welcome to the channel, my name is Daniel, and today we'll be covering Filmora's pan and zoom. Or you could use a really fast pan and zoom to accentuate the beginning like this. Welcome to the channel, my name is Daniel, and today we'll be covering Filmora's pan and zoom. Another pan and zoom effect that I use is the pan and zoom transition. It's similar to the whip pan, but it's done completely in post. What I do is pick a spot somewhere in the frame, usually in one of the corners, and then zoom in on it. For instance, I'm gonna zoom in on the upper left-hand corner. Are you ready? Here we go. Because the camera was moving inward and upward at the same time, technically this is a pan and zoom effect. In fact, I'm using pan and zoom effects right now to accentuate the motion of my hands. I can use this pan and zoom technique to transition into the next piece of footage. Because the camera motion was up and to the left, as if we were throwing it to a new piece of footage, we want the next transition to start from the lower right. That would look something like this. Now let's take those two pieces of footage and put them together. Are you ready? Here we go. Did you see how cool that looked? It looked like some fancy camera motion or expensive transition, but it was actually a simple pan and zoom. Now let me show you how to do both of those in Filmora. With Filmora open and a video clip in your timeline, select the portion where you want your pan and zoom transition to occur. I find that these work best when used rapidly, with around 16 frames of footage used for the entire transition. So from the first piece of footage, let's separate 8 frames from the end of the clip. We want to right-click on that footage and open up the video menu. Click on Crop and Zoom, and a Crop and Zoom window will open up. Click on the Pan and Zoom option, and in the left-hand window, you'll see 2 frames appear, one inside the other. If you look in the lower left of each frame, they say Start and End. These define the size of the first frame and the last frame of your video clip. And once you enter those parameters, the software will automatically create a camera pan or zoom between those two shapes. In our first clip, we want to start with the full frame, then pan and zoom to a very small frame in the upper left-hand corner. So we'll click on the end frame so that we can shrink it and drop it up in the left-hand corner. Click OK and let's move on to our second section. Let's isolate 8 frames from the beginning of this clip. Right-click, click on the crop and zoom, and in the pan and zoom window, we want to reverse this motion. In the left, just above this window, there are 2 arrows. If you click on this, it allows us to swap the 2 frames, making the end frame the start frame and vice versa. Let's shrink the size of the start frame and drag it down to the lower right corner. Click OK, and as always, let's render our footage for smooth playback. Now let's look at our transition. Perfect. The way we do the second half of that transition is exactly how I do the intro I showed you. Isolate about 6 or 8 frames from the beginning of your sequence. Right-click, click pan and zoom, and then click on the arrows to swap the end frame to the start frame. And then just decide where you want to pan in from. A lot of times I like to pick an interesting spot in the frame because even though it goes by really quickly, your brain subconsciously picks up what it sees and it'll recognize it being either something smooth and cool or clunky and awkward. Let's zoom in on my eyes in this case because although I'm never the center of attention in my own household, I am in this piece of footage. And there is our intro zoom shot. You can do this with almost any video editing software, but if you'd like to try Filmora for free, I'll put a link in the description below. But before you do that, do me a favor. Hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, and if you've learned anything here today, hit the like button too. And I promise you, we'll continue this conversation.
Peace.
Wait, here comes the pan and zoom.